Hello guys, and welcome back to another MCreator tutorial. So today we're going to be looking at how to test for blocks. Last episode, what we worked on was getting a block selector and figuring out how to use that. We'll be using that today with the combination of these blocks here. So we have a couple from our previous tutorials, which is how to use basically local variables. Should pop up on the screen around now to use local variables. And then there's also our block selector from the last episode, which I'll also pop up on the screen on using a card. There is also these blocks here. So these are the ones that we're going to be looking at today. And there's a couple more advanced ones, which we'll cover in a little bit in a future video. You can find most of these blocks under the block procedures and then under data and other ones in here. So you can find the get block at X, Y, and Z. You can also get fluid as block at, which is X, Y, and Z. If you scroll all the way down to the bottom, there is one called convert registry name and then the registry name to block or error if conversion fails. So these are the main blocks that we'll be looking at today. There's also two more that we need to get from a different tab. There is the logic, and then we're going to need these two blocks here. So is block the same as block? And then there is block the same block state as block? So these are the two here that we will be using to test for specific locations and stuff like that. It all depends on the combination that you're going to need, and all these blocks have their own little purpose and certain things, so let's cover basically what they do. We'll start with these blocks here. So these ones are conditional based ones. They attach to if statements. So if we have a flow control if statement, we can attach these and make conditions out of them. We can also do a little bit more with them if we wanted to test if a specific location. For example, we can test something in the world if we're using the is block at and get fluid block as, and then the X, Y, and Z. We can actually test for these particular ones here as well. So we have a lot more combinations when we do that. We can actually, for example, with this one, we're testing a specific block, and then we're testing if that block is a certain type of block in the game. So we would test something like this, and that would allow us to get a specific block's location. If the block that where the event is taking place is the same as maybe this block here, then we could basically run a condition based on that. The block state one is a little bit different than testing for an exact block. This one's going to compare the block state as well. So block states are a little bit different. There's a whole wiki page dedicated to block states, but I'll just quickly cover what it means in MCreator. So we'll create a simple block right now, and then we'll go to the block states part, and there's a whole bunch of different properties that are built into the game that use certain block states. For example, like the age ones from 1 to 7, these are all the stages for crops and stuff like that. So that would be that one. There's also directional based ones, up, down, north, south, east, west. So there's a whole bunch of different options for block states and stuff. And you can also create your own block states, integers, and nums, which are like predefined strings, and logic. We haven't covered that just yet. We will in a future video, don't worry. Basically, when you're testing for a block state, you're testing for those values. And there's certain procedure blocks in here that can actually test for specific block states. For example, these ones in this list here can all test for specific block states and stuff like that. So there's a lot of different combinations, but in this case, we'll keep it simple and we're just going to be testing for a simple block. And then we have the convert registry name to block or error if conversion fails. So basically what this will allow you to do is test for namespaces. For example, by default is set up for Minecraft dirt. So what it's going to be doing is it's going to be testing for a specific block in another namespace. It's mostly used for mod compatibility, though in some cases you could technically still do this for your own mod as well. Though if you change the registry or something like that, then this will no longer work. You'll have to update all of them. When is this mostly used and how do we actually use it? So the best way, if you're using something like CCTV craft or another mod namespace, you would have your namespace there, and then you would have a colon, which is the two dots, and then you would have the registry name. Now all things have registry names. Let me just quickly create a block and then I'll show you what the registry is. Okay, so I've created a quick block. If we right click on this and go to edit registry names, we can see that this is the registry name for that particular block. So it's just a bunch of D's in that case. If we go to Minecraft Wiki and go on to block page for just random block, we can scroll down a little bit further where it comes across the ID, and there'll be one for Java Edition. That's the one that you generally want for things like Minecraft ones. Basically, this one would be the identifier. That's the registry name, and the namespace would be under the Minecraft namespace. So if I wanted to add simple monitor, and this would be a block in CCTV Craft 5, the one that I'm actually working on at the moment, we could do that. But the problem is we don't know if that mod is installed at the moment. So what we need to do is we actually need to go to the advanced tab and then scroll down, and we're going to test if the mod exists. So we need to use this block right here, is mod with ID, and then the ID for the mod loaded. So we're going to go ahead and go CCTV craft, and we can use an and statement for this to check if both conditions are true. And we're going to use something like that. This way, if mod is not loaded, the condition will skip over this test completely, and you might have other tests for the script in here, maybe another right-click event or something for your own mod, and you could basically run that instead. So basically, that's how you would go ahead to set something like this up. All right, so let's find a really easy block to do this test with. We're going to look at maybe gravel. So if you press F3 when in-game, you can pop open this menu here. And what you want to look for is on the left hand side. It says target block, and then it will say the condition there. And then if we look just below that line, it says Minecraft colon gravel, and that will show up for any mod. We can also have our own mod. So if we look at this particular block, we can see that just under the target block, it says basically latest, and then it says DDD. That's basically the block registry, and then the latest part is the namespace of the mod. So you can look at any block in another mod and find the registry through the F3 screen, which is the debug screen. So hopefully this helps with a lot of things regarding testing for blocks. All right, so let's talk assignments. I want you to see if you can find a block at a specific block that you right-click on. So make a global trigger, use a condition to right-click on a block, and then what I want you to do is test for a block and right click around in the world on blocks that are not in that list. So what you're not testing for, and then also the blocks that you are testing for. Print out a message to console when you do have that condition true. So basically just type out true, then you will know if the condition returns true. So other than that, if you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe, comment down below, let me know in the video what you liked about it, and I will see you guys in the next one. Thanks for watching. Peace out.